Sequencer is a TR-606 inspired drum sequencer for Eurorack. It is available in both 1U and 3U formats. Analog and MIDI instruments can be controlled, and similarly sequencer can be clocked from analog and MIDI clock sources. Sequencer is optimized for live performance and allows quick programming and editing of drum patterns. This is accomplished by features such as tap recording, various play directions, a global mute mode, an on-the-fly song mode, probability control and an intuitive and quick user interface. This video serves as an introduction to Sequencer and shows its abilities. User interface. In this video I show Sequencer with the 1U version because it's easier to film, but the same features also apply to the 3U version. First, I would like to say a few words about Sequencer's user interface, inputs and outputs. There are 8 instrument outputs here. There's a clock input that doubles as MIDI input. And here's a reset or run stop input that doubles as MIDI output. Sequencer has 16 buttons with LEDs and one function button. The LEDs can be red, blue or purple. A blue LED usually indicates a mode and a red LED a parameter. For example, in this case, the selected instrument is snare drum, the play direction is forward and we are in pattern view. I'm turning on some steps to show you the red LEDs. If an LED is purple, it is red and blue at the same time. In this case here, a step is set and the play direction is forward. Sequencer is a pattern-based sequencer. Each pattern can have up to 16 steps with 8 instrument tracks, and 16 different patterns can be programmed. There are 2 view modes. In pattern view, you can see steps of a pattern, one instrument track at a time. In song view, each button and LED represents a pattern that can be chained to a song. Pattern view. As indicated by the blue LED, we are now in pattern view. Here you can write steps, select instruments, define play directions, set the length of a pattern, and more. To write a step, just press a button and the step is active and shown in red. To clear a step, just press the button again. Currently, the snare drum is selected as the active instrument. To change the active instrument, you can either press and hold the function button and press the instruments button, or long press an instruments button. Let's connect a clock and write a basic pattern. First, I connect a bass drum synthesizer and write a bass drum pattern. I connect a snare drum as well, change the active instrument to snare drum, and program some steps. Let's add some hi-hats and use the tap record function this time. Press and hold the function button and press tap. Now, the instrument can be recorded using the instrument buttons, and also via MIDI, by the way. To exit tap mode, press the function button. To clear the currently active track, press and hold the function key and hold clear. As long as clear is pressed, the currently playing steps are cleared. To change the play direction to forwards or backwards, press and hold the function button and press back or forward. To select ping pong or random direction, press and hold function and long press the direction buttons. Random play direction does not play all the steps completely random, but uses an algorithm to produce musical results. And now switch back to the forward direction. To change the length of a pattern, use last step. Press and hold function and last step, and you can now see the last step of the pattern in red, Here, step number 16. By pressing buttons, you can change the last step easily. To exit last step, press function again. To copy the currently active instrument track, press and hold function and long press copy. The track is now copied and can be pasted into another instrument or into another pattern. I would like to paste the copied track into the low tom instrument, so I select it, and to paste, press function and long press paste. It is also possible to mute instruments. This works globally across all patterns. To access mute mode, press and hold function and then press mute. Here we can see the 8 instruments, and whenever they are triggered, the LED turns off for a moment. Currently all instruments are unmuted, but with the press of a button they can be muted. The upper 8 buttons in mute mode are for probability control. Here you can define which instruments react to probability. Currently none does, but I now turn on probability for the hi-hats. Probability is controlled via the low and high tom instruments. Each step, the probability of an instrument playing is evaluated in the following way. If no tom is programmed, the instrument influenced by the probability will always play. If only the low tom is programmed, the instrument will only play with a probability of 75%. If only the high tom is set, the probability is 50%, and finally, if both toms are set, it is 25%. If I now set steps into the tom tracks, you can hear how it influences the hi-hat instruments. To save program patterns, songs and configuration, press and hold function and long press save. Song view. To enter song view, press the function button and press song. Here, each button and LED represents one pattern. The currently active pattern is blinking, and patterns that are part of a song are shown in red. In order to change a pattern immediately, just press one of the buttons. If you go back to pattern view, you can now see the contents of this pattern and modify it. There are two ways to chain patterns to a song. If you just press a pattern button and hold it, you can now add other patterns to the song by pressing other buttons. The maximum number of patterns in a song is 32, and one pattern can be added multiple times. When you release all buttons, the currently playing pattern will finish playing and the first pattern of the new song will start. A slightly different method to program a song is to long press the first pattern of a song. Now, the pad and song LEDs light up to indicate song programming mode. You can now just press the pattern buttons in the order you want them in the song. When you're finished, press the function button and a new song will start in sync. Note that in both cases a new song can be programmed while another is still playing. Often, creating a variation of existing patterns is quicker than creating a new pattern from scratch. In SongView, you can easily copy and paste patterns. To do so, press the function button, press copy, and select the pattern to copy. Now, you can press func and paste, and by pressing pattern buttons, paste this pattern into multiple pattern slots. When finished, press function again. Now all four patterns have the same content, and we can create variations, either by editing the patterns one at a time in pattern view, or by chaining them to a song and editing them live in pattern view. Tap recording, mute, and last step are also available in SongView. Similar to the play directions in pattern mode, you can also change the play direction of a song. The song can play forward, backward, ping pong or randomly, while the pattern play direction is completely independent and not changed. Config menu. The config menu contains settings and configurations that are only occasionally needed. To enter the config menu, press and hold the function button and then long press conf. Here, parameters are shown in blue and their values are shown in red. Included with Sequencer is this config menu cheat sheet for both 1U and 3U versions. And of course, you can also find a detailed explanation in the user manual. In the config menu, you can change the MIDI input and output channels, set the clock source and divider for the MIDI clock, adjust the pulse length of the instrument outputs, set the LED brightness and define the link mode. As an example, I will set the clock source to MIDI clock and change the clock divider. To select MIDI clock as clock source, press the function button and press the button for clock mode. As you can see, currently the clock mode is set to reset. Without pressing Funk, we can set the clock mode to MIDI I/O by pressing the SD button. If we now start a MIDI clock, the sequencer starts. We can now change the clock divider. Press Funk and SD to select the clock divider parameter. Currently it is set to 16th, and by the press of a button we can change it to a variety of values, such as 8th, quarter notes, 3/16th, or a whole bar. To exit the config menu, press the function button and conf. Clocking options. There are various ways to clock sequencer by both analog and MIDI clock. Four clock modes are available. In reset mode, sequencer is clocked by an analog clock at the clock input, and the sequencer is reset when the reset input goes high. In run-stop mode, the sequencer is running as long as the signal at the run-stop input is high and stopped if low. In MIDI I/O mode, sequencer is clocked and started via MIDI and also outputs MIDI at the MIDI output. Finally, clock MIDI mode is a hybrid. Here, sequencer is clocked with an analog clock but outputs MIDI. Pulse length. The pulse length of the outputs can also be set in the config menu. Lengths between 1 millisecond and 100 milliseconds are available. Here you can also switch sequencer to gate mode to output gates instead of pulses. An interesting setting is clock width. Here, the pulse length is matched to the pulse width of an analog clock. If you change the pulse width of the clock, the pulse width of the sequencer changes with it. Linking sequencers. Using the link interface on the back, multiple sequencers can be linked to create longer patterns or more instrument tracks. Sequencers can be connected directly or using our link patch bay to dynamically change connections. The first sequencer acts as the controller, accepting clock or MIDI sync and forwarding it to other sequencers. There are two link modes, serial and parallel. In serial mode, the controller forwards its clock to create longer patterns. When changing the active instrument on the controller, linked sequencers will follow. Likewise, mute, tap and clear also works across sequencers, allowing to record long patterns and muting globally. All sequencers will output the same instrument triggers in serial mode. However, the pulse length may be set differently. Here, the pulse length of the first sequencer is set to 1 millisecond and the second one to 100 milliseconds. You can hear the difference when I plug the symbol from the first into the second. Songs are not synced in link mode. This allows to create evolving song structures. For example, if the songs of two sequences have different lengths. Or if one sequencer plays its song randomly. This concludes the tutorial. There are more features I have not shown. Accented steps can have different pulse lengths, many parameters can be controlled via MIDI CC, sequencer can act as a drum MIDI interface, and link modes can be combined. It is always worth checking out the user manual, which is included with sequencer or can be found on our website.